In this lecture, we'll continue our study for the particle accelerators. In this lecture, we'll study another two types of the accelerators, synchrotron and the betatron. Let's start with the most famous accelerator, the synchrotron. In this synchrotron, we have a donut shape circuit or device in which there is magnetic field. And there is somewhere in this donut shape, we have some two plates on which I will apply a voltage, Va. And somewhere I will make injection for the particles. For example, from this point. If I make injection like this, this particle, for example, electron, will find a perpendicular magnetic field inside this tube. So it will move in a circle, like this, until it reaches this point. If this electron, it will find between these two plates positive voltage here, negative voltage here, so it will be accelerated and take energy equal to QVA, the voltage between these two plates. And the particle will be increased in speed or velocity, will be accelerated. When it comes out, it will find the same magnetic, the magnetic field, so it will continue also in circular motion. In the second cycle, it will go another time between these two plates, so it will take another QVA, so it will accelerate it more. Comes out, magnetic field, go in a circular motion, enter these two plates, gains another, a third QVA. So in each cycle, the electron gains energy equal to QVA. So after n cycles, the total energy of the electron will be n QVA. And of course, this will be translated into a kinetic energy, half m Vn squared. So the velocity at cycle number n equal to square root of 2n QVA over m. So as we increase more and more the number of cycles, the velocity will be increased. There is a problem here. This tube has a constant radius. And so I must be sure that in each cycle, the electron will move along the same circle with the same radius. But we have a problem. The radius is equal to mv over qb. And in each cycle, the velocity is increasing, so R must be increased. But it should be constant. So what can I do for this? In each cycle, I should increase also B. For example, V after any cycle is equal to this value. So R is equal to M, square root of N to N QV over M, over QB. Getting B here and R here in the denominator. So Bn, the magnetic field at cycle number n, is equal to m over qr square root of 2n qv over m. So at the first cycle, when n equal to 1, B should be m over qr square root of 2 qv over m. At the second cycle, B should be m over qr square root of 2 multiplied by 2 qva over m. Should be increased. Third cycle, 2 multiplied by 3. Fourth cycle, 2 multiplied by 4, and so on. Using this way, the increase in V will be cancelled by the increase in B, and R kept constant. Okay, the last accelerator is called betatron. And this is the idea in the betatron is based on the idea that the change in magnetic field over time will create electromotive force. This electromotive force, from the name, it's electric, will create an electric field. So we have also a tube with some injection and some ejection tube, some inlet and some outlet, and we have also in this tube we have a magnetic field, perpendicular electric magnetic field. When I inject the electron from the inlet here, it will find a perpendicular magnetic field, so it will move in a circle. But this magnetic field is increased with time, so it will create electromotive force EMF, which is proportional to the change in the magnetic flux by time, which in turn proportional to the change in the magnetic flux density by time. So this electromotive electric field will be increased by time, and it will accelerate the electron. So the electron will move in a circular path and will be increased in velocity also. We have a problem. If I make injection at this point, B will be increased, so the electromotive force will be increased also. But at this point, the magnetic field will be decreased. So it will deaccelerate the particle, the electron for example. So I must make ejection for the particles or the electrons at this point. So if I make injection at this point, I must make ejection at this point. So at this point, I will inject the electrons from this site. And after some time, this time, I should eject the electron from this outlet. And no ejection will be in this time duration. Until I reach this point, at the second cycle, I make another injection. And at this point, after another T, I will make ejection. And so on and so forth.